Christmas series. And today we're talking about Leicester. Rodgers transitioned to more of a 4-2-3-1 last season rather than kind of his 4-3-3 where he had Maddison and Tielemans working as 2-8s. I think that's because he recognises that Maddison does perform better as a 10. And so he looked to try and fit that in. Goalkeeper Schmeichel was once again one of the best keepers in the league, and he'll be their number one again. Danny Ward, I think, is a great number two. Is Danny Ward still there? I just want to check that. Yeah, saying that he is currently still there. Yeah, great number two to have, to be honest. So, yeah, no issues needed there. No replacements needed there. Right back, Ricardo Pereira. He's had some injury problems last season. When fit, he's a really good player, I think. Leicester are going to obviously hope that his injury record improves for the coming season. But they've got James Justin and Timothy Castagne, who can also play there. So right back is pretty stacked. Centre back on paper, this position is well covered with Fofana, Evans and Soyuncu. With Vestergaard and Amati as backup, Fofana's injury really didn't help last season. Soyuncu was dramatically out of form for periods. I think this year perhaps isn't the year where an upgrade is needed, though. And hopefully these players can, you know, just get back to form. Really, that's what we're hoping for. Left back, they've got Castagne, Justin, Luke Thomas, and Bertrand, who can all play there comfortably. Luke Thomas was decent in his position. Ideally, though, I think it'd be good to see Pereira on the right and Castagne on the left on a regular basis. I think that's where Leicester would be strongest. DM, that's undoubtedly indeed his position, and he had another good season before his injury. Bibakari, Samari, and Nambliss Mende can also play there as backup as well. Centre mid, you've got Youri Tielemans in the heart of Leicester's midfield, and he did really well once again. Obviously, there was a lot of talk about him going to Arsenal, and that seems to have really cooled now. It seems to me like Tielemans staying might be quite a strong possibility, in all honesty, which is probably why we haven't seen any activity from Leicester in the market so far. I'm going to base this on the basis that he does end up staying. My gut's telling me that no one's going to get him. And Hamza Choudhury, Kieran Dewsbury, all they're good backup, so no replacements there. At number 10, you've got Maddison, that's definitely his position. 12 goals and 8 assists last year, it was really strong. They'll want him to build on that momentum. There's other players that can fill in that position as well, and if needs be, the formation could be tweaked if Maddison isn't fit as well. On the right wing, I think that's the position that they could really do with an upgrade. On the left, they've got Harvey Barnes, he's the main man there. You've got Albrighton and Perez who can fill in there. Striker, you've got Vardy, Patson Daka, and Iheanacho, and I think that's enough firepower up top completely. So for me, right now, with Tielemans staying, I'd just go and get one player, which would be the right wing, and that means that you could splash a bit of cash, really, if you're only having to bring in one player. So I'd go and get Moussa Diaby of Bayer Leverkusen if they can. I know Newcastle are rumoured with him, but if Leicester can go and get him, then happy days. And that'd give us a new starting 11 of Schmeichel in net, Pereira at right back, centre back, and probably be going for Fofana and Evans at this stage. Left back Castagne, DM and Didi, centre mid Tielemans, attacking mid Maddison, left wing Barnes, right wing Diaby, striker Vardy. And, you know, I think that team could definitely push further back up the league than 8th if things fall into place for Leicester in terms of consistency and, you know, more luck with injuries. Short and sweet for Leicester, guys, but, you know, that's kind of where I see things for Leicester for this coming season. Let me know your thoughts in the comments, as always.